Video 2.5, SPI and I2C in Nano RP2040 Connect. In this video, we will cover the following topics. What is SPI? How to work with SPI in Nano RP2040? What is I2C? How to work with I2C in Nano RP2040? SPI stands for Serial Peripheral Interface, a common communication protocol widely used by microcontrollers to establish communication with one or more peripherals rapidly over short distances. The peripherals can be any sensor that supports SPI protocol or a microcontroller. SPI supports high-speed data transmission and is very simple to implement. Infinite bits can be sent or received in a continuous stream. Other communication protocols like I2C and UART send data in packets. Hence, they can send a specific number of bits at a time. On the other hand, the data transmission in SPI is always done one bit at a time. SPI is a four-wired communication protocol between two devices in a master-slave configuration. Generally, a master is a microcontroller unit and a slave may be a sensor or other MCU. The number of masters cannot be more than one, but the number of slaves can be unlimited. The number of slaves is limited to the load capacity of the master. The four connections needed for SPI communication are MOSI, master out, slave in, MISO, master in, slave out, SCK, serial clock, SS or CS, slave select or chip select. SPI is a synchronous serial data protocol capable of transmitting data at a speed of up to 10 Mbps. Let us now look at the steps of data transmission through SPI. The master outputs a clock signal. To activate the slave, the master switches the SS-CS pin to a low voltage state. The data from master to slave is sent along the MOSI line. To get back a response, the slave returns data to the master along the MISO line. Let's take a look at the SPI protocol on the Arduino Nano RP2040 board. Instead of master-slave terminology discussed earlier, Arduino prefers to use the term controller and peripherals for master and slaves. The signals named MOSI and MISO are named COPI and CIPO respectively, where COPI stands for controller out peripheral in and CIPO stands for controller in peripheral out. The pins used for SPI protocol on the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect are digital pin 12 as CIPO, digital pin 11 as COPI, digital pin 13 as SCK, any GPIO except A6 and A7 as CS or SS. To use SPI protocol with Arduino Nano RP2040, we first need to include a header file named spi.h by writing an include statement. digitalWrite chipSelectPin, low statement is used to activate the slave by pulling down SS or CS pin as we discussed earlier in this lecture. spi.transferAddress is used to select the address for the slave device. For example, if the slave address is 0x0A, the statement we write will be spi.transfer0x0A. The data is transferred using the statement spi.transferValue, where value is the data that needs to be transferred. After the data is transmitted, we write the statement digitalWrite chipSelectPin, high to indicate the transfer is over and the slave is free now. After gaining basic familiarity with SPI protocol, let us now learn about the I2C communication protocol. I2C stands for Inter-Integrated Circuit, a serial communication protocol used to transfer data bit by bit along a single wire. Similar to SPI, I2C is also a synchronous serial data protocol and follows a master-slave terminology. Synchronization specifies that the output bits are synchronized into the sampling bits by a clock signal shared between the master and the slave. The control of the clock signal is always with the master. I2C supports four types of communication. Single master to a single slave, single master to multiple slaves, multiple masters to a single slave, multiple masters to multiple slaves. Unlike SPI communication, I2C only uses two wires, SDA and SCL, to transmit data between devices, where SDA stands for serial data and SCL stands for serial clock. I2C provides a synchronous serial type communication with a speed of up to 5 Mbps. If the microcontroller sends an 8-bit slave address, the maximum number of slaves connected to a master cannot exceed 128. 7 bits indicates the slave address, since a 7-bit number can be from 0 to 127, so the maximum slave devices can be 128. 1 bit is sent by the master to slave to let slave know whether master wants to read from or write to the slave device. If the bit is 0, the master is writing to the slave, and if the bit is 1, the master wants to read from the slave. Some of the microcontrollers are also capable of sending a 10-bit slave address. With I2C, the data is transferred in packets containing these blocks: start condition, address frame, read-write bit, data frames, ACK or NACK bit, that is acknowledgement. Let us now look at the steps of data transmission through I2C. Master switches the SDA line from high logic to low logic before switching the SCL line from high to low to send the start condition to every slave. Master sends a 7 or 10 bit address to the slave along with the read or write bit to which the master wants to communicate. Each slave compares the received address to its address. If the address matches, the slave returns an ACK bit by pulling the SDA line low. Master sends or receives the data frame. After each data frame is received, the slave returns another ACK bit to the master to acknowledge a successful reset of the frame. Master switches SCL high before switching SDA high to send a stop condition to the slave. The pins used for I2C communication on the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect are analog pin A4 for serial data or SDA, analog pin A5 for serial clock or SCL. To use the I2C protocol with Arduino Nano RP2040, we first need to include a header file named wire.h by writing an include statement. To initialize the library, we write wire.begin function inside void setup. Wire.begin transmission 1 statement specifies that it begins transmission to device 1. To send data, wire.write value is used, where the value indicates the data to be transmitted to the slave. Finally, a command wire.end transmission function is used to stop the transmission. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: what is SPI, how to work with SPI in Nano RP2040, what is I2C, how to work with I2C in Nano RP2040. In the next video, we will get an overview of the Arduino IoT Cloud.